we will cover a small topic. It's quite interesting, but this is with a lot of dilemma in different cultures. And this syndrome used to be called as mass hysteria or mass psychosis or group hysteria or group psychosis. And they used to think that, you know, people used to get crazy in bulk. And after a lot of research is conducted on these people and analysis conducted on these people, they decided probably like they are not real. And this is due to the intercultural or the effect of culture or different cultures on human behavior. So in DSM-4, they group such syndromes into one category, which is called as cultural or culture-bound syndrome, or we call it CBS. And if you remember, such words might be used, for example, as mass hysteria or group hysteria, once you work in like different localities. But right now, if you try to find it in DSM, you won't find, because they discontinued such terms long time ago. Now we are going to call them, all of them, as cultural bound syndrome, because like categorizing all of them into one group right now. And it was available in DSM-4. Okay, let's see what it is. So what do we find? This is a phenomenon where you'll be finding combined syndromes, or this is a phenomenon with combination of psychiatric and somatic presentations, which means they might be showing you something like delusions. They might be showing something connected to their somatic presentation. For example, they might get like spasms, they might get stomach pains, they might think that like they have some kind of bulge in their body, or like some tumor in their body. So all of them are called as what? Somatic symptoms or somatic presentation. We already studied a group of disorders. They are called as somatoform disorders. I already explained about what is the classification, how it was changed from DSM-4 to DSM-5. So if predominant presentation is connected to somatic presentation, we call them as somatoform disorders. Now here what you are finding, you have some psychiatric presentation and you have some somatic presentation, but this is going to be bound only to a culture or to a group of people, which means other group of people don't have such presentations. So it is fixed for a group of people or a culture. That's why they are defining this as culture-bound syndrome. Previously it was called, I also wrote, you can see over here in purple color, previously it was considered as group psychosis, group hysteria, or mass hysteria. They discontinued such terms and they introduced a new term called CBS, or we call it culture-bound syndrome, in DSM-4. And they are explaining this way. This is recurrent, locality-specific pattern of aberrant behavior and troubling or troublesome experiences that may or may not be linked to other diagnostic category. The issue here is most of the presentations are what? Somatic. Which means you can think that this might be a presentation connected to anxiety disorders. That's why, but usually this will be presented in a specific culture or a specific group of people, or it can be a family too. That's why it cannot be recognized by other group of people, so they are bringing a new category in DSM-4 as culture-bound syndrome, which means you get psychiatric presentation, you get somatic presentation, but this is recognized by only one group of population. It can be a culture, it can be a family, it can be a group of people, which means this is not generalized. Then we call it culture-bound syndrome. Is it clear? So next thing you can see over here, if you try to go for the criteria, we don't have any clear-cut criteria for this. It's very difficult to classify they are really crazy, or they have cultural-bound syndrome, or they are malingering. You have to go for a very clear interview. So this is a big work, because they can act like they are having something which we call as malingering, or they might be having really psychiatric disorder. For example, schizophrenic people might be saying you about bizarre delusions. So you might think probably this is a cultural-bound syndrome. But in case of cultural-bound syndrome, for example, group of people are getting more or less same or similar presentation. It is contagious only within that group, and other people don't recognize such syndromes. Today we are going to talk about this. So if you ask, Do they have any clear-cut criteria? It is not fixed. Nothing is clear here. But they almost managed to get a group of criteria or characteristics for defining CBS or culture bound syndrome. You can see one by one. Categorized as a disease in that particular culture or a particular group of people. Sometimes it might be happening in some families. Widespread familiarity only in that culture, which means that if you talk about such a syndrome, people in that culture will recognize this. I'll tell you a term, Soodu. If you are from Tamil Nadu, you will understand this term. People calling something called Soodu, or they call it Ushnam. So grandmothers and grandfathers used to say that, you know, when children get stomach pain, they say that, you have Soodu. Soodu means heat. So the heat gets into your body. Yes, it gets into your body and it is causing all these deleterious effects in your body. So you can get dysuria or burning urination. You can get like stomach pain. You can get even pelvic pain. And it is considered to be something called as Soodu. Technically, there's nothing. In case of summer, you are going to get dehydrated. You might be getting some presentation due to dehydration, not due to the entrance of this heat into your body. But old people used to perceive this as heat entering into your body and causing all these effects. But if I talk about the Soodu, of course, like people from Tamil Nadu would recognize, but people from other parts of India might not recognize. That's why you can see this is widespread familiarity in that culture only. Other people do not recognize this. So unknown to other cultures. What is next? No objectively demonstrable biochemical or organ abnormality. Now think about this part in case of schizophrenia, in case of depression or organic dementia. Other term, what is the new term which we studied last class? This is called neurocognitive disorders, where you will be finding organ abnormalities. You can take CT and you can find out something. You can take MRI and find out something. Some biochemical abnormalities can be found in many disorders. You don't find anything over here. The last thing, usually this is treated by folklore medicine or traditional medicine. Talking about this part, this is not real. People believe something is there. So which means in psychiatry, how do we treat these people? Only by counseling. The best thing is what? You educate the patient. This is called psychoeducation. But if the syndrome is usually associated with anxiety disorders, in this case, you should treat the anxiety disorder because probably this anxiety disorder is pushing them to do such things. So the presentation might be associated with some real psychiatric disorder. So which means you should educate the patient, plus you should treat the underlying cause. Only in some conditions we might be needing like pharmacotherapy and other therapy in case of very aggressive cases. Otherwise, this is treated by counseling because it's not real.